Welcome to Ballet Dance Live podcast with weekly portion of stories, tips and dance inspiration. My name is Iana Komarnytska, I'm your host and I invite you to explore all nuances of Ballet Dance Live together with me and our amazing guests. Let's start! Hello everyone, how are you doing? How's it going? Today we have a mini episode on the podcast and I decided to try something new. In fact, after our recent interview with Serkan Tutar, then we touched a topic of what is the difference between style and personality or individual style and all the different views and approaches we have to those words and descriptions. I got inspired to share with you a little part of our interview with Marta Korzun. So for those who heard it, it will be a great reminder and review of a great tips that Marta gave. And for those who didn't hear it, it would be great inspiration to go back to actually episode number one, the very first episode of the podcast, first interview with Marta Korzun, and maybe listen to it again. So here is a little part. Then I asked Marta about how to develop individual style, your own individual style or personality in your dance, and here is what she replied. Do you have any tips or tricks or suggestions how to find and develop the individual style?
I don't know if it like a tip, but just will tell you how I work with my students. I think, in my opinion, that almost all of them really have different style. I hope so. So how I do? Of course, in the beginning, of this competition life or just dance life, it's absolutely normal if all your students, they look the same and they look like you. Yes, but because it's normal, because they try to copy the teacher, it's normal. But after, for example, if I create choreography now, yes, we do it together. I create some part and then I ask my students, do you want to put another movement here? If you want to put some movement that you feel that will be really good in this part of music, it's okay for me, yes? Because I know that some teachers, they say, no, you shouldn't change my choreography and only like this. So for me, I don't work like this. I work in a combination with them. And also, I always push them and I'm really proud of them. I push them to take to go to workshops to take classes with different teachers. Because you know it, yes, that you take something from this teacher, from everyone, and your body will remember this. And also when I ask all the time them to improvise, I record them all the time and show them, send them later. And you can see they dance amazing in this improvisation. They sometimes show me some combinations that I never use. I have never used. Mm-hmm. And I say, from where you know this? They say, I don't know. And they say, of course, because you went to this workshop, So I ask them to work also by themselves, you know, without me. So try to do without me, or I do this, I can help you. Try to do this choreography by yourself, bring to me, and I will check if it's correct, if it's logical, you know, to help you in some moments, but try to do by yourself. And now I think like half of my students, they create choreography for themselves, by themselves, yes? And I just check if it's okay or no. I think it's really nice way to find your own style, yes? And one moment, sometimes students, I don't talk now about my students, but in general, if they go to competition, they, for example, know that now will be these three judges, and they start to check the videos of these judges and create choreographies, in order to be nice for them, you know, like not in their own style, not how they want to dance. They took some combinations from these dancers, yes, and put in their dance. But I don't think that it's a nice way. Do you understand? Yes, what I mean?
Yes,
just
yes.
You want to be nice for these three people. Yes, but I realized also in my own experience, I also did it before. Yes, that it's better to dance what you want, how you feel it. Not how this judge wants you to dance, and then you will win. Yes, only like that. Only if you like it, not somebody. So I don't know if I'm answering your question. I hope so. But
oh,
it's
yes,
how I
yes,
work. So
sure.
just to visit as many workshops as you can, as you want. Yes, and try to create, improvise. And try to create maybe combinations by yourself, how you feel the music. Yes? And it's nice if somebody who is more experienced will check it. Yes? Ask for somebody's mm-hmm. advice if it's nice choreography. But anyway, you will work, you know, like your brain will start to work in another, not level, but like another direction. Not just trust your teacher. It's good in the beginning, but then you should try to work by yourself, and only like this you will create your own style. Because if you will dance somebody's choreography, of course you will then dance in style of this choreographer. That's like this.
Thank you for listening, everyone. I hope you enjoyed this episode, and if so, do you know the best way to support this project is to share it with your friends. It takes a few seconds, costs you nothing, but it helps a lot to move this project forward and help me to bring more awesome guests on the podcast in the future. You can tell your friend, you can send a message, email, you can screenshot and put a post on social media, whatever works better for you. But if every one of you will share this episode at least with one more person, it will make a huge difference for this podcast. Thank you for spending your time with us, for your support and love. And until next time, keep shimmying, keep dancing, and I will see you soon.